In today's episode, let's check out Nirmalya Forestwood Dhoop Sticks. Namaste everyone, and welcome to Om Incense Show with DJ, a show that helps you increase your incense quotient. So if you are an incense enthusiast, consider subscribing. In these type of episodes, we first check out the packaging and fragrance of the incense. Then we talk a little about the incense world, and we wrap up this episode with a quiz, so you might want to stay here till the end. So this is the Forestwood Dhoop Sticks from Nirmalya, and this is how it is. It says made from flowers, and there is a dhoop in a circle, so we can see that. And the overall feel is that of green, and if you can see, they've made leaves on this green. So just check this out to give it an overall feel of the forest. So that's the kind of branding they've done for this pack. And as usual, on the other side we have Nirmalya fragrances and the beautiful Nirmalya logo with fragrances written there in golden. And on the back side again, we have the same thing that's written in all of their packs. So it's nirmalya.com, and Nirmalya meaning pure. Nirmalya made from flowers. With Nirmalya, you add to the livelihood of the women who are dedicatedly preparing these incense sticks. With Nirmalya, you protect the holy rivers from being polluted. With Nirmalya, you get CSIR certified organic products. With Nirmalya, you take home a little fragrance of purity. And then we have directions of use, and then the three logos, and which says Nirmalya made from flowers, toxic free, 100% natural certified, handmade, made in India with love. And it says based on technology from CSIR, SciMap. And then they have the usual thing. It says manufacturing September 21, quantity is 20 in numbers, and the MRP is 150, but I think I got it for 127 or so. You might want to check out the website for the current rate. And on the other two sides, on the sides where we need to open the pack, we have the Nirmalya tape, you know, it's the branded tape that we have. And like most of the incense sticks and the dhoop sticks, this also is a it's a pyramidal shaped box. And this is what we have. This is how it looks in totality. So that's Nirmalya Forestwood Dhoop Sticks. So we open it up like that, and with this also we got this free dhoop cup, the Havan cup that we have, that they call. This is what we got free inside this pack. We also had a dhoop holder here. I'm sorry, I can't locate it at the moment. It's just a simple ceramic dhoop holder, dhoop stick holder. So this is what they have. And so what we have inside this pack is a simple plastic pouch that carries the 20 sticks that they have. Oh, it's nice. So the dhoop stick is just a normal dhoop stick. It's that thick, and it's almost as big as my index finger, and that's how it is. I believe this will last around 20 to 30 minutes, because given the thickness and given the size of it, it will last around 20 to 30 minutes. And the fragrance is very nice. It will actually remind you of some temple in the Himachal or the Uttaranchal, you know, where nestled between the forest there is a temple, and you get that fragrance from there. You know, I somehow, those temples have a typical fragrance, not because of only the incense that is lit up there, also probably the kind of oil that they use for the lamps, that also matters. And the overall surrounding, the overall environment that is there also lends a typical fragrance to the to the forest. Like, you know, all the places have a typical fragrance of their own. Like the plains will have a different fragrance. Bengal has a different fragrance. South India has a different fragrance. You go to any market, they will have a typical fragrance, you know, that is very typical of that place. So if you've ever been to forests and you mountains, and if you've been to any of those temples in the mountains, this is the typical kind of fragrance that you get there. I mean, I could, the first whiff, and I could just, and I was like transported in that temple. It's like that. It's very typical, that temple fragrance is very typical. I remember I buy essential oils for my soap making from this guy, and I'd asked him, I said, I'd gone to Kashmir and I really like that fragrance. So I said, you know, I want the fragrance of pine. Then he said, you know what, the kind of fragrance that you are getting there in that place cannot be captured in a bottle. What we get in bottle is just the thickest form, the most, the purest form of the essential oil that is there in the botanical, which has been forcefully extracted. So it's like the soul of it, but the fragrance that you get in that place is not what can be captured in a bottle, because the fragrance that you're getting there is not only because of the essential oils that is there in the trees, which is being emanated continuously, but also the soil, the air, the overall environment of that place, the kind of lifestyle that those people have, is what gives it, is what lends that place that fragrance. So that is not something that you'll get in the bottle. And also the fragrance, when it has been forcefully captured, is quite different from that which is being naturally emitted in a place. So no matter how hard you try, no matter what kind of what kind of method you use, the fragrance that is there of a place cannot be captured in a bottle in its entirety, because it is not just one thing that lends the fragrance to that place. It is the overall environment and a lot many factors that, you know, gives that place its fragrance. So this fragrance is typically, very typically, of any of the temples, you know, nestled amidst the forests in the Himachal or the Uttaranchal. I've not been to any other, you know, places where this doesn't remind me of any other place. This typically reminds me of temples located inside the forest in Himachal or Uttaranchal. So if you've been to Mukteshwar, there's this temple, Mukteshwar Mahadev temple. If you've been to Manali, we have Hidimba temple. So that's the kind of fragrance that I get from here. It's a very, very nice, very nice fragrance. It's very, very woody, very foresty, very, very typical foresty kind of sacred smell that it is. That's the kind of fragrance we have here. Now let's light up the incense and check out the fragrance that it gives out once it has been lit up. So let's check this out. Upon lighting up, the first whiff that I got was of a wood, like it's normal for all the incenses. So I got that whiff of wood. And then after a few moments, you start to get that fragrance that you were getting from the cold incense. However, in the cold incense, it was very pronounced, and upon lighting up, it has diluted a lot. So it comes across as very, very mild, extremely mild. So, you know, you will have to be in the room for some time to exactly know that there's this kind of fragrance that's been lit up somewhere, the incense that has been lit up somewhere. That fragrance that we were getting from the cold, incense, the temple kind of fragrance has been. So you get only 20% of that fragrance here once it has been lit up. And the feelings that I had when I smelled the cold incense is not here at the moment. Probably I'll have to be in this room and let the incense light up, you know, let the incense burn through the entire incense. Probably then you'll get that kind of fragrance. So you get only 20% fragrance of what you had in the cold incense. Upon being lit up, this is just a normal incense, a normal, you know, a regular incense. You don't get that fragrance, that nice temple fragrance that you had in the cold incense. It's not there in the fragrance of it, in the smoke of the incense. So this is like just any regular incense. If you like very mild fragrance, very, very mild fragrance, then you would want to go for this, because this is the kind of fragrance which is really mild, and probably the entire incense stick would have to be used up to give exactly the kind of fragrance that we got from the cold incense. Very mild, very mild. So that's what we have here. So this is Nirmalya Forest Wood Dhoop Sticks. 20 sticks for 150 rupees, or probably 130, 127, something like that. You might want to check out the link in the description and visit their website to check out the current rate, because they always keep giving some or the other discount, and they also have you know, discounts on the gift boxes and discounts on if you buy say two or three boxes together. So you might want to just check out the Forest Wood from Nirmalya. If you are, you know, if you're taken up by the fact that they have used the temple flowers for the fragrance, I mean temple flowers for the incense, then let me just tell you one thing, that temple flowers, or any other flower for that matter, is just one ingredient of the entire incense base, or the incense ingredient, and it really doesn't add up anything else to the incense per se. So it doesn't add up any edge to the incense per se. But yes, they're doing a good work by cleaning up the rivers, and they have actually cleaned up quite a lot. And so this is a good thing that way. And as for the fact on, you know, employing women, I think most incense makers employ women for their products. So I don't think that's a big deal. As in, yeah, it is a big deal for women getting, you know, employment, the rural women. But not just this incense brand, any other incense brand like Cycle also employs women. So that is the one thing I just wanted you to know. The other thing is, I have noticed that in most of the new incense makers who are there, whose purpose is not just to make incense, you know, they are here to clean up the environment, to, you know, give and to give employment to the women, and there are so many other things that they want to do along with, you know, making incense. Or probably because they are just new in the field, the kind of fragrances that they come up with is quite different from the ones that the established incense makers do. So most of these new incense makers come up with fragrances which are like very typically single notes, or even if they are blends, they're like pure blends, and they're like not diluted with any other fragrance notes. So it doesn't, that's what I feel, to me it doesn't give out, it gives out a more sharp kind of fragrance, which is like if you like that single note fragrance, you would like it. If not, you would be totally off it. Like for oud, for rose, for patchouli, for dragon's blood, most of these incenses, what I've noticed is the new incense makers give you just that fragrance, you know, that incense fragrance, that the star ingredient incense fragrance that you get. But brands like Cycle will give you a more rounded version of that fragrance. So even if I don't like oud fragrance per se, so I did not like the fragrance of Mukhalat from Nirmalya, or Phool from sorry, oud from Phool, I still like the oud from Cycle brand, because the oud from Cycle brand was very rounded off. It was more floral with one tinge of oud, whereas Mukhalat and oud from Phool were very strong oud. I have somehow noticed that with most of the fragrances, you know, with most of the incenses in these by these people. So the new incense makers would always capture the single notes you know, well. So if you like that kind of very single note, you know, where you light up the incense and it's like completely divided into two, you get one single note fragrance and then you get one something else. But in incenses where they have been manufactured by incense makers, the traditional incense makers, which have been in this field for generations, for years, you know, for hundreds of years, they come up with fragrance where you do get that, you know, that nuanced fragrance of the star ingredient, but you also get an overall fragrance which seems more rounded off. So I just thought, you know, that's the kind of experiences that I have had with incenses. So I just thought might as well share that with you. And let me know in the comment section below, what are your views on fragrances? So if you are an incense enthusiast, I'm sure you by now you must have been able to make this out. So that is the one thing I'd wanted to discuss with you. Now in our last quiz, I'd asked, name the two trees that lends the forests of Uttaranchal. It's that typical citrusy fresh forest fragrance. So the answer that Vidyadhanji also gave, and the answer is Cedrus deodara, that is Devdar, and Pinus roxburghii, that is pine. So these are the two trees that are found mostly in the jungles of Uttaranchal. And you know, if you go to Mussoorie, Dhanaulti, all those areas, you will get a very typical nice citrusy fresh forest fragrance where you will be, you know, you can smell the soil, you can smell the sky, you can smell the air and the forest trees. It's a very typical, very nice, very invigorating, refreshing, rejuvenating kind of fragrance. So that these are the two trees that are mostly found there that lends the fragrance to that forest. So, and the reason I did forest wood today is what I wanted to compare that fragrance with this one. So yes, in the cold incense you did get that kind of fragrance where you were actually transported to a temple which is inside a forest and you get that fragrance. But upon lighting up the incense, fragrance diluted quite a lot. Around, it just came down to around 10 to 20%. So you have to be in one room with this incense lit up, and the entire incense will have to be burnt through to actually get the fragrance that you got from the cold fragrance, from the cold incense. So that's the thing. Now the quiz for today is, name the incense resin that we get from the tree whose Latin name is Ailanthus truffosa. Ailanthus truffosa, the resin that we get from that tree. Just name the resin. So I hope you liked today's episode and learned something from it. If you think somebody else can learn something from it too, share it with them. We also have a Hindi episodes, the Hindi incense channel Om Dhoop Show. So if you want to check out these incense episodes in Hindi, agar aap Hindi mein in episodes ko dekhna chahte hain, to aap humare Hindi channel ko dekhe, Om Dhoop Show. Aur us par aapko ye sare Hindi episodes mil jayenge. So we've just started that Hindi channel, and in case you're interested in watching the Hindi episodes, you might just want to check out Om Dhoop Show. And just let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, whatever you think about the forest wood fragrance and the, you know, the overall incense fragrance profile that I gave you about the new incense makers and the established ones. Just let me know your thoughts there. And till we meet again next, take very good care of yourself. Namaste.